In this Ledger Nano X setup tutorial, I'm going to show you how to physically set up your Ledger device step by step, while also showing you all the possible benefits and security features. Then I'll show you how to set up your Ledger Live app the correct way, and then connecting it to MetaMask to make transactions. So make sure to stick with me till the end for that. Now we're going to set up our Ledger Nano X wallet. So you're going to need our 24-word seed phrase recovery sheet, our Ledger Nano X, and our USB-C cable. And from here, you would open your Ledger Nano X, plug in your USB cable into the computer, and then onto your Ledger Nano X device until it clicks and then it switches on and the welcome screen shows up. Now the Ledger Nano X only has two buttons, the left and the right. The left button is usually going back or clicking left, and the right button is usually going to the right or going forward with a task. And to accept or say yes to anything, you'll need to press both the buttons at the same time. Now, a quick note with the flicker on the screen, this is only happening because of the camera that's recording this video. In real life, when you're working with your Ledger Nano X, it won't have this problem, I guarantee it. Now, moving forward, we right click until we get to the screen that says set up as new device. However, if you want to restore an existing wallet from your recovery phase, then skip this step and go to the next part in the timeline where I show you how to do this. But to start with, let's set up as new device and double tap these two buttons to continue. Now we need to choose a PIN. It can be 4 digits up to 8 digits. I'm just going to do 4 digits to keep it simple for this example. Double press again. I'm just going to choose 1111. So by pressing the left button, you're going down in the numbers. And by pressing right, you're going up. And then double tap to press OK. So we would do this until we get 4 numbers. And we would simply double tap when it says tick here. And now I need to reconfirm the numbers one more time and then confirm PIN. Now this is where our recovery sheet comes in handy, and we'll need to write down all 24 words onto the sheet. Now we right tap all the way until it says press both buttons to continue. Here's our first word, isolate. Write this down and then right tap for the next word. We would keep doing this for all 24 words before moving on to the next step. Now that we've got all 24 words written down, you can right click one more time, and now we'll double tap, and you'll have to confirm your recovery phrase by choosing the correct 24 words one by one. For example, confirm word one, it is isolate, so I need to right click until I find isolate, then double tap. We'll do this for all 24 words. And while I do this, don't get any sneaky ideas and try and log into my wallet. There's going to be no money in there, as I'm only showing my seed phrase for this tutorial only. But if you want to go through the massive pain of entering all these words, be my guest. Now that we've entered everything in, right tap until it says press both buttons to continue. You would do that. Let the Ledger Nano X process. And now your device is ready. Now this next step is where this 24 word seed phrase, which we've written out together, comes in very handy, and you must keep it safe and not share with anyone. Although you can feel free to share the like button to this video, I assure you that's very safe. We're now gonna use this 24 word seed phrase to recover our existing wallet into this new device. And you would do this if you lost your hardware wallet or it was damaged and doesn't work anymore, and you need to put your wallet into the new device. So I'm first going to take you back to the original screen when you bought the device, and we can do this by holding these two buttons, where it will take you to the settings, double tap on that, go to security and double tap. Now we will go down to reset device, double tap, and reset device. We would enter in our 4-digit PIN which we created before, and now our ledger has been reset to the factory settings. Now we go right all the way until it says restore from recovery phrase. And now we will double tap this and choose a new PIN. Double tap again. I'm going to enter in the PIN and I'll use the same one again. And now you would have to enter in all your 24 word recovery phrase. And here are 3 different options with the 24 words, 18 words and 12 word seed phrase. You would do this, for example, if you have a MetaMask wallet with a 12-word seed phrase and you want to put it onto your ledger, then you can do that. However, I don't recommend you do this at all, because your MetaMask wallet is a hot wallet which can be accessed via the internet anyway. So by setting it up on the Ledger, it sort of defeats the purpose, because people or you or someone else can still access this wallet through your MetaMask account. So it's not fully safe like this hardware wallet on its own. So I always recommend setting up your Ledger on its own and leave it disconnected from everywhere else. So I choose the 24 words. And now the first word I have to enter in letter by letter, isolate, starting with the letter I. And now it gives you the option of different choices of the words that start with I and S. Now we pick the right one, and we would do this step over and over until the 24th word. I know this is very tedious, but it also shows you the importance of writing down your seed phrase, getting it right, and putting it somewhere safe. And once again, your device is ready, and we can move on to the next step. The next step is to install our Ledger Live app. You can do this by going to ledger.com/start and then clicking on download. Choose your operating system. In my case, it's Windows app, so I'll choose that. Then you'll download it. And once it is ready, we'll open it up and then we'll click on install and complete the installation process. And once the download is complete, you'll be presented with this page where you can click on get started, agree to the terms and privacy policy, then click on enter Ledger app. Now you can select three different devices, but in this tutorial it's a Ledger Nano X, so I'll click on that. Now we're presented with three different options to access our Ledger. We can either start fresh, or we can connect to our existing Nano X, or we store from recovery seed phrase. Now if you've done the previous step with me, then you're going to choose one of the bottom two. But most likely it's going to be connect to your Nano X here. So I'll click on this button. Now click continue. And before you click on check my Nano, we need to connect our physical Ledger Nano X device to our computer. So I'll plug it in, enter in my PIN code, and now click on check my Nano. Now double tap here on your device, and it shows that my Ledger Nano X is genuine, so we can click continue and move on to the next step. Now, first of all, before doing anything else, you must update your firmware on both your Ledger Live app and your Ledger Nano X device if they're not up to date. And this is very important for your Ledger device, because there is a small problem with the Ledger devices whereby if you don't update them for a few months and they've skipped a few software updates, then sometimes there's a problem that occurs where you can't update your device and you have to do a hard manual software update, which is a pain to deal with. So I recommend you do an update once a month. Now to update, you click on Manager and then click Update Firmware here. Agree that you have your recovery phrase saved like we've written down together previously, and click Continue. Now let the firmware download finish and then double tap to confirm the new firmware installation. And then right tap and then double tap to confirm the new firmware installation. Now we need to re-enter in our PIN code. And now our firmware shows that it's been updated successfully. Now we can also check if our Ledger Live app is updated by going to Settings, About, and then checking that this version is up to date. If it's not, there'll be a download button here where you can install the new version. And now an important side note that I must recommend you do is to go to the General section, and under password lock, you need to turn this on. And this is a must use security settings that I recommend to you. And then also make sure to have your auto lock set to a certain number of minutes. So this means in this case, every time I log in, I must put in a password, and after I'm idle on the app for 10 minutes or longer, it's going to automatically log me out. This is another layer of protection to keep your account safe from hackers. So make sure you do this now. Now that we got all the nitty-gritty stuff out of the way, we're ready for the next step of adding our crypto wallet to our Ledger device. We can go back to the Manager section. Now you can choose all the different cryptocurrencies you can add. In this case, I'm just going to do Bitcoin and Ethereum. So I'll click on Install, wait for it to download and install to your Ledger Nano X device. And now we're ready to add our new wallet. We can go to our Portfolio section here and click on Add Account. And in this example, I'm going to use Bitcoin. So I'll create a Bitcoin wallet here and click on Continue. Now we need to go to our Ledger Nano X and double tap this button. And now we can see there's two choices to choose from for me because I already have an existing account. But if I want to also create a new account, I can select this instead. I'll stick to my existing account and then click on Add Account. Click Done, and there it is. You can see my wallet here. This means that we're now ready to send and receive our cryptocurrency. And I'm gonna show you this right now. So let's receive crypto into our wallet first. We can do that by going to Receive, select our wallet, click Continue, copy our address. Now right tap on our Ledger Nano X device to make sure everything's fine, and then click Approve by double tapping it. Now click on Done on our screen. So now we've copied our address. Now you need to send Bitcoin into this address. If you don't have a location yet where you buy Bitcoin, then I strongly recommend you use FTX. FTX is one of the biggest and most trusted cryptocurrency exchange in the world. And this is a platform that I trade as well myself, as they have really low fees. So if you don't have an account yet, then I recommend you use my link here to get started, as you'll get a reduction on trading fees forever. Now let's send some Bitcoin from FTX to our Ledger Nano X wallet. We'll click on Withdraw, select the amount you want to send. In this case, I want to send everything, so I'll click Max. In the BTC address section, this is where we'll enter in the address that we copied from our Ledger Live app. Now enter in the two-factor authentication code, and if you're happy with everything and double checked everything, then you click on Withdraw. Now we can go back to our Ledger Live app, give it a few minutes for the funds to arrive. And now you can see that our funds have arrived. And now we're ready to move on to the next and very important step, and that is to use MetaMask with your Ledger Nano X device. This is something that you must know if you want to do any sort of DeFi interaction. So if you don't have a MetaMask wallet yet, then I recommend you go to metamask.io and download the extension. But if you need more help on setting this up and everything to do with MetaMask, then I recommend you watch this next video here. And I'll leave the link in this video's description as well, so you can check it out after this video. So now if you have MetaMask set up, you can click here, click on the three dots and expand view. This will open up a big page and enable you to do things much easier. So now we need to connect our Ledger Nano X device to MetaMask. And we can do that by clicking here and then click Connect Hardware Wallet. Choose Ledger and now go back to our Ledger Nano X. Exit out of Bitcoin by tapping the right button and then double tap on Quit. And now we need to choose Ethereum and double tap on that. And now we're connecting to MetaMask. Click on Continue on our screen. Select the Nano X device, click on Connect. Choose a wallet that you want to connect with. It can be any of these, but in this case, I'm going to choose this one. Click on Unlock, and there's my Ledger device connected. Now we need to figure out how to send and receive crypto into your Ledger Nano X wallet. Let's start by receiving some funds. We can click here and copy our wallet address, go to any other account, and now we're going to send some money from that account into our Ledger Nano X wallet. So we'll go to send, paste in our Ledger Nano X wallet, select the amount that we want to send to that wallet. I'll do 0.1 here, click next, make sure you're happy with the gas fees. You can always edit it if you need it lower, but you don't have to really worry here because we're on the Polygon network and not Ethereum, so the gas fee is very minimal. If you're happy with that, then click on confirm, go back to our Ledger Nano X wallet address, and you should see it update in a few seconds with an additional 0.1. There it is, right on time. It's very fast on Polygon. And that's why I chose this chain in this tutorial. So now we want to send crypto out of our Ledger Nano X wallet. So now I'm gonna go and copy any other address that I want to send to. Go back to my Ledger, click on Send, paste in the address I want to send my crypto to, and select the amount. I'm gonna use 0.1 again, click Next, check the fees, click Confirm. And now I need to review the transaction on my Ledger Nano X device, tapping the right button to check the amount, check the address, check the network, and check the fees that they're all correct. And if they are, then double tap to accept. Now this is going to remove 0.1 Matic plus some fees out of our account. And there it is. It's sent. So this should update and be 0.4 something. And bang, done. Now, if you want more information on this Ledger Nano X, then I recommend you check out this next video here, where I do a full in-depth review on the product But if you're looking for an alternative to this device, then check out this video where I show you which is the best hardware wallet for you. So check it out and I'll see you over in the next tutorial.